Mr. Ambassador.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Senator Lugar, it's a pleasure to be here with you, both of you, this morning, and I look forward to a useful exchange of views, and we'll try very hard to respond to all of your questions.
Can you pull the mic a little closer, please?
Sure. Is that better?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. I would just, to sort of introduce this subject, supplement the prepared statement that has been submitted and say that the United States has been struggling with the issue of nuclear weapons in North Korea for the past 25 years. There have been times when we've made some progress, only unfortunately to see it largely slip away. We have been able to deal with its provocations, but North Korea poses an enduring challenge to U.S. interests in the region and the interests of all other countries in the region. They are a pole of instability in the heart of what is arguably the most important economic region of the world today. They are also, of course, a major threat to American and other norms regarding proliferation of nuclear weapons. So this is a challenge that must be dealt with. We do not have the option, in my judgment, of simply biding our time and ignoring them. In response to the provocations which Kirk Campbell has described, what we have pursued is essentially a two-track policy. On the one hand, working very closely with our allies and our partners in the six-party talks, we have, through the United Nations and bilaterally, tightened our sanctions on North Korea. It is difficult to measure the exact effect of those sanctions, but this is something we work at every day. We are constantly coordinating with all of the partners in the North in the six-party process to ensure that the sanctions achieve maximum effectiveness. And I think there is no question that the sanctions have made life more complicated and more difficult for the DPRK. At the same time, however, we recognize that sanctions are not in and of themselves a full policy toward this problem. So we have remained and will remain open to constructive dialogue. And we view diplomacy ultimately as the best way of solving these difficulties and this challenge. We have been in constant coordination with our partners in the region, particularly with South Korea and Japan, but also with China and Russia. We are engaged in efforts to make sure that, on the one hand, the sanctions remain effective, tightened, and on the other hand, to demonstrate that we are serious about the use of diplomacy, but serious in the sense that we want assurance that North Korea regards these prospective talks seriously. We are not interested in talking just for the sake of talking. We want talks which produce concrete results. We remain committed, as do our other partners in the six-party process, at least South Korea, Japan, China, and Russia, to full implementation of the agreed statement, the joint statement of September 2005, which pledged continued concentration on non-proliferation and other elements to bring about stability on the Korean Peninsula. On the subject of food aid, which has been described, been raised earlier, we continue to pursue a long-standing U.S. Policy on food aid. We do separate humanitarian assistance from political issues, but we provide food aid when we see a perceived need and in a situation in which we can monitor how the food aid is used, who are the recipients of that food aid, and does it go to the people for whom we intend it. On the subject of human rights and other humanitarian issues, I am very pleased to be working very closely with my friend and colleague Bob King, who is part of our office. We talk frequently and closely coordinate on all issues. Bob has just returned from an extended trip to South Korea, where subjects including North Korean human rights performance, food aid, the general situation on the Korean Peninsula in North Korea have been very prominent on his agenda. So I think that this relationship gives evidence of the fact that as we approach the problems of North Korea and the challenges that it poses, we are very concerned about human rights, and we are very concerned about the condition of the North Korean people. So I will stop there and, like my friend Kirk Campbell, make myself available for your questions. Thank you.